Like many new fabricators, you picked up a welder and wondered, what project can I build first to learn and practice my new tool on? For me, it was designing and building my own welding cart. Which I used to store my Mig Welder, gear, and keep my garage space in order so that everything I needed was within reach. Hi, I'm Ratha Sochenda, and in this video, I'll guide you through on how I designed and built my welding cart for my Mig Welder. This was my previous setup, a cheap hybrid freight cart that came with the welder when I first bought it off Craigslist. After owning it for some time, I found out what I didn't like about it. The main one being that the tank was too tall and heavy, causing it to lean. It works, but sometimes depending on what side the tank leaned, it would kink the hose that connected the tank to the Mig Welder. The other issue was trying to go mobile. At times, it would be difficult to maneuver because the whole frame would flex, making it feel pretty flimsy. A quick fix would have been just to get a smaller tank, but because I was going to run dual Mig TIG in the near future, this cart wasn't going to work anyways. I spent a few weeks researching different welding carts I could buy, but none were quite right. Frustrated and motivated, I decided to build one myself. I've had some previous fab work from the last project I did, which was a roof rack for my 4Runner, but this was my first cart ever. To see what others had done, I hopped onto YouTube University, Pinterest, and Instagram to gather ideas. I started by sketching a few ideas in 3D. I created a layout sketch and modeled the frame in Solidworks. I ended up with something like this, a tubular frame with three racks, the top being for the main Mig welder, the second maybe for storage or like a pullout tray, and the third for like an optional machine such as a TIG welder. Having the option to do a secondary machine meant I had to make sure the cart would be wide enough to add a second tank. And because I have limited space in my garage, I went the route of designing the cart vertical versus horizontal. With the design locked in, I finalized all the measurements and created a cut list for all the materials I would need for this project. For the metal, I went to my local metal yard and had the 20-foot sticks cut down for ease of transport. Because I've already created a digital blueprint of the cart, I was able to plan ahead. I printed out the drawing plans, which included a detailed cut list with measurements and quantity along with how everything is assembled. I'll leave a link in the description if you guys want to follow along or build your own. Now let's cut. Having a plan laid out took out all the guesswork. I measured and marked and then used my metal bandsaw to cut the tubes. I had a chop saw laying around, but I actually wanted to use my metal bandsaw because I didn't want sparks flying all over the place. It's slower, but I wasn't in a rush. After I got all my pieces cut, I deburred it with a flat disc on my grinder. I started out with the base rack because I wanted a good foundation for the remaining racks to build off of. I spent a great amount of time getting this all squared away. Now let's do some welding. Once I got all the racks done, now was to add the side braces to connect all three of them together.
So pretty much how I got this guy jigged up was I actually used a spare piece here, spare tube laying around. I actually clamped it down here right in the middle. And then so this top rack had something to rest against. To get to the desired angle, I got my little digital angle here. And it adjusted it to 95 degrees because I wanted a little bit of ramp. Pretty much stick this guy here like this. And then if I needed to adjust it, I just take my rubber mallet here and I just hit this piece here and then this would slide down just enough to where I got it perfect. And then I just made sure everything was aligned. And then I pretty much clamped everything on there. And now I'm ready to weld.
Now let's add some wheels. For the fronts, I actually chose to go with a polyurethane threadable swivel type wheel because I wanted something smooth and quiet and easy to move around, and I wanted it heavy duty. I could have welded them on, but chose to make mounting place to fasten to, just in case I needed to swap them out if they went bad. I then pre-assembled them to make sure the mounting hardware would clear the frame and welds. Once stacked in place, I removed the casters and finished up the welds. Now I move to the back wheels. Because the back wheels were a little bit larger, I had to offset the axle mounting point to make sure the cart was level with the ground. To make the cart structurally sound and to support a second tank in the near future, I end up using a piece of solid rod to serve as an axle to connect to the wheels. To fasten them down, I tapped each end, then added some spacers or collars to offset the wheels from revving the frame. Then capped everything off with a low profile nylon lock nut. Now it's time to go for a test ride. I felt like a kid again. It was like running up to one of those grocery carts while holding the rails coasting down the aisle. It was pretty cool. Securing the tank was the next task on the list, and probably the most important one. I wanted to keep it simple but functional. I designed a swing on arm mechanism. I got this idea when I was looking for a rear spare tire to carry for my Toyota 4Runner. It's pretty simple. I used a weld-on hinge to allow the arm to rotate and used a latch clamp to lock it into place. I allowed a little bit of gap here because I was going to insert one of those plastic inserts to cap it off and keep it nice and flush. This allowed me to quickly swap out the tank if needed. I actually ended up redoing this part because I found out that the 150 CF tank I had also comes in a 7-inch diameter tank and a 7.5-inch diameter tank. Therefore, I made it wide enough to accommodate both sizes. To make it easier to move the cart around the garage, ended up making a front handle out of some round tube that I had laying around. Teamed it up with some square tubing, and I think it worked out pretty good. I was actually gonna go with just square tubing completely, but I think having the round tubing is just a little bit easier on the hands. I guess I'm sensitive like that. Just playing. As far as kit management, I never really had a good way of, you know, organizing my MIG welding cable along with my ground cable. It always just kind of wrapped around, you know, my welder itself or somewhere around the tank. So I figured I'd come up with a way to keep it all nice and organized and taut. I ended up using some flat bar and some round tubing. And then I just kind of placed it on the side of the frame and offsetted it. And then looped the cable around to figure out my distance that I need to offset the brackets from one another. And then I tacked it into place and seemed to work out pretty good. When I looped it around too, I actually just used one of the tube holes to kind of hold my MIG gun. And the flat bar I just used to clamp on my grounding cable. To make it somewhat show-worthy, and to protect it from the elements, I end up using some self-etching primer and some machine gray Rust-Oleum spray paint that I picked up from Home Depot. And here's kind of a quick preview on how this gray turned out. I'm always misplaced my work gloves. I think it's because I never really had a dedicated place for them. So I came up with the idea of removing an old clip off an old clipboard. And then I just figured I'd rivet it onto the frame. It actually worked out better than I thought. Originally, I was going to make some custom brackets to hold my welding helmet, but I ended up just using the ones off my old welding cart, and it worked out pretty good. In a nutshell, that's my welding cart setup. It's easy to move around, and it's stable. I now have a cart that can be easily modified to add a second machine. I've been using it around the garage, and I've got to say, this thing is super stout. Most importantly, I don't have to worry about the tank ever tipping over, especially when my kids are in the garage running around. I hope by sharing my story here, it might encourage some of you to start your own DIY project. When I first started, I was nervous but excited. It took some time, but I learned so much in the process, and I can say it was totally worth it. I've created a playlist of all my favorite metalworking videos. Check it out in the description. If you want to build a cart like this or want to support the channel, I've added a link in the description to the PDF plans. You can make the same one or modify it to fit your needs. Finishing this project has inspired me to start a few more. If you want to follow along and see the behind the scenes stuff, check me out on Instagram at Ratha.Sochenda. If you guys have any questions, just leave me a comment and I'll do my best to try to answer it. If you guys like this video, hit the thumbs up and subscribe for more stuff like this. I'll see you guys in the next one. Later.